Hey everyone, Dan here with another video, and today we're going to be going over one of my favorite special chapters in My Hero Academia Vigilantes. Special chapters are available to those who actually purchase the volume of Vigilantes. So I figure, on an off week, let's go over one of those chapters. In this particular chapter, everyone's favorite detective Naomasa Tsukauchi is trying to get a handle on the situation in Naruhata because between vigilantes and instant villains, there's one hero who's completely neglecting any of the paperwork or civil duties that come with being a hero. All Might. With that being said, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell and throw up a like if you like the video. And let's dive in and see how Tsukauchi found out that Toshinori Yagi is All Might. Okay, so the chapter starts off with Naomasa inside of All Might's agency, Might Tower. Tsukauchi finds out that All Might is actually in Hokkaido at the moment, and he should be back pretty shortly. When suddenly, the TV behind Tsukauchi is drawing a crowd. Turns out, the villain attack in Hokkaido has attracted some media attention, and some dude dressed as a cowboy is attacking what looks like a ranch. When suddenly, All Might shows up and chops the guy in the neck, and as a reward for apprehending the villain, the farmer provides All Might with a big ol' mug of milk. Nothing like a mug of cold milk on a hot day, am I right? Either way, All Might accepts the many gifts from the man and goes on his way. Almost simultaneously, he arrives back at Might Tower and he's barraged by reporters asking him several questions, amongst them what kind of underwear that he wears. He deflects and says that he has to go, and then he vanishes behind something known as the Might Gate. We find out later that the Might Gate is actually used by All Might to cool down after he's elapsed his time limit as All Might. But yeah, as All Might vanishes, the disheartened Tsukauchi remembers the note that his partner Tanuma gave him. If you were unable to get in contact with All Might, your best bet is contacting his secretary, Toshinori Yagi. As he pulls out the note to present it to the secretaries at the front desk, coincidentally, Toshinori is already at the front desk and notices the officer. With that being said, Toshinori brings the young detective upstairs to the cafeteria, a place that he adds he loves to be because he gets a great view of the city and he loves to people watch. From there, the frail man introduces himself as Toshinori Yagi, from Might Productions' secondary clerical office. What that pretty much means is that Toshinori is in charge of everything in All Might's personal life. Naomasa says that he really didn't think that All Might had any privacy whatsoever, to which Toshinori says, yeah, it pretty much means that he barely has any work to do, and that his job consists of him primarily getting messages to All Might. Naomasa, with a smile on his face, says that Toshinori must be a pretty trusted confidant if he knows the face behind the man. But Tsukauchi is here for a reason. He has to talk to Toshinori about All Might. See, in the previous special chapter that maybe I'll go over eventually, a meeting takes place about the instant villain problem plaguing Naruhata. Every major hero was pretty much in attendance, from Ingenium to Eraserhead to Endeavor, but it was lacking one person, All Might. And as Tsukauchi starts to explain the situation, from outside it's heard by both of them that a purse snatcher has appeared. Toshinori quickly states that he's gotta go to the bathroom and excuses himself. We then get one of my favorite scenes in the manga. Now you guys know me, I'm a huge fan of Marvel and DC, and this scene right here is a straight up homage to Superman. The frail and sickly man dashes into the bathroom, rips off his suit and tie, and below it, we see that this frail man is in fact the symbol of peace, All Might. The next panel, we see All Might taking down the villains in a blink of the eye, and then suddenly, he's back at the table with Tsukauchi. Then, another incident happens, a hit and run, when Toshinori makes another excuse about his stomach hurting again and stops the hit and run and the driver effortlessly. And as he returns to the table one last time, four more incidents occur, from a girl having a cat stuck in a tree to an entire bridge falling. So what does All Might do? He pretty much saves everyone simultaneously. Like, if you look here, he stops the bridge from falling and he's holding the cat that he saved. Then the next panel happens. Tsukauchi looking at All Might, pretty much blown away, because All Might didn't really do a pretty good job at, you know, redressing after coming back in. So here's this disheveled All Might standing there right in front of him with his hero outfit in plain sight, and he's still holding the cat. Tsukauchi kinda goes, hey dude, you still kinda have the cat, and All Might freaks out and goes, oh my god, I have the cat. He goes and returns the cat to the person, but then he returns to the table and just stares at Tsukauchi real quick, and just kind of pleads with the young police officer not to tell anybody about his secret identity. Tsukauchi actually kind of commiserates and says that it must be kind of hard trying to lay low, and saying that he's not the type of person to go and immediately blab about the secret identity of the number one hero. But now knowing that the person in front of him is All Might, Tsukauchi starts going off. He states that the police are starting to see All Might's habits as rather unsettling, Being a hero means that you're a civil servant, and upon defeating a hero or committing a heroic act in general, the paperwork has to get done. If you don't do it, you're just as bad as a vigilante. All Might then kinda starts to tear up here and says that, look man, I'm just trying to do my best. And that he really isn't capable of doing paperwork, because he feels like he has to keep an adequate distance away from people so they don't find out his identity. If somebody does his paperwork, they'll know who he is and they'll find out his identity relatively quickly. He states that once upon a time he had someone that he could trust, he had a sidekick, but ever since a certain incident, he's gone. Sidebar here, really cool that we see Night Eye. It pretty much guarantees that this chapter happens after the fight against All For One. All Might then expresses himself in a way that Koichi would probably sympathize with. All Might understands that there's rules and there's regulations when a hero has to exercise their right as a hero. But it's like putting the car before the horse in that case, because he feels like he shouldn't have to do the paperwork just to save someone. And he states that is really trying to help everybody that he possibly can a bad thing? And Tsukauchi is an understanding person, but he kind of takes what All Might says and throws it right back in his face. Because no matter the justification that All Might might have for not doing paperwork, if the number one hero doesn't set a good example for all other heroes and starts to ignore that law, it sets the nation on a road towards anarchy. Like, Japan already has one of the best crime rates throughout the entire world. We find that out way after, but still. But Tsukauchi decides to do All Might a favor, as a fan and as a friend. When All Might has to go out and do something, all that Tsukauchi asks is that All Might gives him a call. That way, Tsukauchi can immediately start drafting the paperwork for him, and he can label his impromptu rescuings as emergency dispatchments. All Might's overjoyed because for the first time in a while, he's actually able to exchange contact information with somebody that he can genuinely call a friend. The last panel of the special chapter has an overwhelmed Tsukauchi sitting at a desk with his 10th phone call, with All Might apologizing for overwhelming him with so much work. Tsukauchi then looks at his partner Tanuma and says, "You really gave me this on purpose, didn't you?" When Tanuma says, "Yeah, that guy Toshinori was a..." And the chapter ends. So yeah, fun little chapter in between story arcs. This chapter marks the moment where the investigation against Queen Hachisuka truly begins. Also, a quick little note here about the court queen bee. I'm starting to think that Queen Hachisuka is just a name that Knuckle Duster's daughter came up with to hide her identity for the moment. That's how she was able to separate herself from the attacks and murders across Naruhata. Police were looking for somebody that had that name and that quirk. That being said, I think we have a situation where it's like Principal Nezu. The animal has a quirk itself, and what you can do is manipulate that bee to your own advantage. Also, this would kind of justify why Knuckle Duster has suddenly vanished. Like, he has to get Tamao out of here. She's pretty much a wanted person. If anyone sees her face, they're going to be able to associate the face with the crimes, so that's why he's gone. He might show up, though, for all we know. But if anyone has ever seen an episode of Monsters Inside Me, when a bug lays, like, eggs inside your brain, you usually don't stay on the side of sane. Either way, this chapter was amazing. It helps us thoroughly understand the timeline to a degree. Like Tsukauchi not being present for the fight against All Might and All For One. We know that from this chapter that they met during Vigilantes. So pretty much, let's say that 5 years ago, the incident happened, and then All Might and Night Eye have their falling out maybe like 6 months into that whole incident. So this coincidental meeting between All Might and Tsukauchi, it could be taking place relatively close to our current timeline, at least within 4 years. Because think about it this way, you're not gonna really try to get on the bad side of the number one hero. So you really probably wouldn't come after him until like 6 months or like a year of him like neglecting his paperwork. Let's be real here. Nobody is gonna complain about All Might going around saving everybody except for the cops. He makes the police just, you know, look inefficient. But the thing is, All Might's only one half of that system. And people eventually are gonna be like, yo, when did this happen? Why is this guy sitting here? Did he commit a crime? Did anyone file a report for it? I mean, what do you mean All Might was the person on scene? Where is he? Where is the report? Tsukauchi! And then the next thing you know, it's on Tsukauchi's desk, where Tanuma tells him that, yo, you gotta figure this out and find out what the hell's going on with All Might. We can't keep answering questions from the government and the budget committees with shrug emojis. Also, a quick little aesthetic about one of the scenes. I love this moment right here, where All Might has the cat. It's like just a giant metaphor for the cat being out of the bag. I just wanted to point that out. It's really funny. It's something I really like about these special chapters. It really does like a lot more world building rather than showing you the vigilantes. But other than that, that's how Tsukauchi met All Might and found out his secret identity. It's pretty wild how people in this universe really don't go through a lot to try to hide their identities as heroes. It kind of makes me fear for Inko Midoriya. Deku really never wears his mask, and it could seriously just be putting her in danger. every time that he handles a villain, people could just be like, oh, Izuku Midoriya, do you have a mother? Oh, I'm just gonna go and, you know, kill her because I don't like you. You know, it's kind of like what Ending did. Ending didn't like Endeavor, and he tried to kill Natsu. It's just one and one. Granted, Ending got the hands, but either way, any other person, if that could have been them, their family member could have been dead. But yeah, if you want to tell me your thoughts, be sure to reach out to me in the comments or tweet at me at DanExclaims. Other than that, this is Dan, signing off. Peace.